What's going on, guys? My name is Triforce Addiction. Welcome back to another COD Mobile video. So today we are going to be doing yet again another episode of the Blueprints of Call of Duty Mobile. And this time we are going to be discussing the Razorback Aurora Borealis. So I know it does have a different name. I think it's called the Boreal Aegis or whatever. But I'm just going to call it the Aurora Borealis because it sounds a lot better. And yeah, I don't want to feel like an idiot mispronouncing this name. So right off the bat, I want to let you guys know that this isn't actually a new legendary skin for the Razorback per se. So the reason being is that this weapon has already been released for the Chinese version of COD Mobile a while back, and it's barely making its way into this game right now. So I just want to clarify things right there, because just in case you guys are thinking that this is new, technically it's not. But for Global and Garena, yeah, it's basically new. So what is there to say about this weapon? Well, really there's a lot, and don't worry, I'm going to have a comparison video, basically a versus for the Necessary Diplomacy and the Aurora Borealis variations. So stay tuned for that. But as of right now, we're just going to focus on the Aurora Borealis version of this weapon. So this is the weapon where a lot of people would say that this is what the Razorback should have gotten from the very beginning instead of the Necessary Diplomacy. Because right off the bat, I mean, in terms of appearances, this weapon is far superior to the Necessary Diplomacy. I mean, in terms of death effects, in terms of animations, in terms of the iron sight, the shooting effect, this weapon is superior in every single way. So just like the Necessary Diplomacy, it is a reactive camo. It does change colors depending on the combo kills. And once you've reached the final one, it does have those animation effects turning into different colors like yellow, orange, green, and just all these various colors, as well as having the Aurora Borealis effect just around the weapon in general. So yeah, you could pretty much say the appearance of this weapon does seem to compete very well against the Dark Matter and the cosmic variations of this weapon. So obviously one of the biggest selling points for this weapon is of course the iron sight. So the iron sight is far more different than the base version of the Razorback. So of course the Razorback has a more obstructing sight, you know, having that square in the front, so sometimes it can be a little hard to see the enemy. So yeah, it's not really the greatest sight in the world, but with this skin, it does alleviate that entire issue, basically giving you a full sight picture. So now let's get down to the attachment section of this video. So of course, on one side, we do have the attachments that this blueprint came with. And of course, we have the class setup for you guys on the right side. So for the attachments that it comes with, we do have the extended light barrel, the strike stock, sleight of hand, stippled grip tape, and extended mag A. So for the class setup, I have, of course, the MIP extended light barrel, the rapid fire, OWC laser tactical, rubberized grip tape, and extended mag A. So at this point in time, the rapid fire perk is by far the bread and butter for the Razorback. If you don't have this, you are going to struggle a lot with this weapon. But if you do have the rapid fire perk already equipped to your weapon, it should be a much easier time compared to before. So now we get to the question of whether or not it's actually worth buying. So this weapon, or I guess this skin, does change this weapon dramatically. It makes it look absolutely beautiful with northern light effects all over the place. You know, the Aurora Borealis is such a great theme that goes with this weapon. And I feel like this should have been the legendary back in Season 13 instead of the Necessary Diplomacy, because this one just basically knocks most of the legendaries out of the water. There are not a lot of legendary skins in this game that could compete with this one. I mean, this by far is one of the best ones, if not the best. So really, it all comes down to the choice of the player of whether or not they want to buy it. For me, like, I love the Razorback. I've been using this weapon for like such a long time now, and it's nice that we finally have a legendary that's worth buying. But that's just my opinion. But anyways, I hope you guys enjoyed. Make sure to leave a like. Stay tuned for the comparison video between the Necessary Diplomacy and the Aurora Borealis skin. So anyways, I'll see you guys next time. Make sure to, you know, leave a like and everything, because it does help the channel a lot. And have a wonderful day.